Well, I guess since the 24th of November, everybody has been waiting with bated breath who's going to be the men's senior national coach. I know it's a very important announcement. The media has been after me. The media has been after everybody to see who will be the men's national coach. I want to tell people something. Football and professional sport is a brutal game. World Cup qualifying, it's about results and getting to the World Cup. If the results don't go your way, you got to do something different. Tom Saintfiet has been one of the several candidates that was on the list and recommended by the technical committee. He'll be our new men's senior national coach. He's Belgian, was the youngest manager in the Belgian scheme of things. He came highly recommended as well. He worked in difficult situations in Africa, and we feel that he can do the job for us. I will also tell you this, that if he doesn't get the job done on the 24th and 28th of March, he'll be looking for a job. And I make no apologies to say that. He's laughing, but we're very serious. Because if we don't get the result on the 24th and on the 28th of March, we might as well kiss our campaign goodbye. So ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Tom Saintfiet, the Saint, is our new men's national coach. Vidya, over to you.
Thank you very much, David. John Williams, president of the TTFA. So we've heard who the new national men's coach is, so let's get him to the podium. So I'm sure he has a few words to say, so please welcome to the podium at this time, Mr. Tom Saintfiet, the new national men's senior head coach.
Thank you. Welcome everyone. Not used to be here, normally I talk on the table, but okay, I will adapt. I'm honored and pleased to be here. You heard the words of the president. There were several candidates, and Trinidad and Tobago is naturally a football nation with huge reputation through history, a few times close to the World Cup, and in 2006 finally to the World Cup. So I think a lot of coaches will be jealous that I'm standing here. I will introduce very short who I am. After that, I will tell you why I'm here and also a little bit looking forward to the plan. What are my ambitions, the way to work, what are my thoughts about local football here. First of all, in the media was already something written. Sadly enough, the information was mostly incorrect. I'm 43 years old, with a pro license, Belgian citizen. Worked already with 8 national teams, sometimes in difficult situations. Important to know is that I never got fired by any federation where I worked. I worked many times in short-term deals, in difficult missions, and most of the time I brought it to good results. I worked also on club level in different continents, in Africa, in Europe, and in Asia. I have near my way for pro license. I'm a psychologist, specialized sport and business psychologist, a physical coaching degree and skill development degree. And I was a former football player, not as brilliant as some others, but I kicked on professional and semi-professional football. I kicked the ball. I had to stop on a young age because I had 6 times cruciate ligament injury. That's the reason why I started on a young age as a coach. That's maybe a little bit about CV. The rest you can Google. If you Google right, you find the right information, even on Wikipedia. Maybe more the reason I'm here. I started already. Many coaches will be jealous that I'm here and not them. Trinidad and Tobago is a football country with a huge history, but I believe with a more huge future. At the moment, the current situation is that they are still in the running for the 2 big tournaments. The Gold Cup first, the important matches, the playoffs will be played in January. And I think for a nation as Trinidad and Tobago, it's a must to qualify for this kind of tournaments. Suriname and Haiti are not easy opponents, but with a good preparation and with the right tactical approach and all details, we must be able to pass that hurdle. and then go to the last playoff match against the fifth of Central America. The next goal, naturally, is and maybe the most inspiring goal is going to the World Cup. 2006, Trinidad was there. I think for the rest of the world, it was the first time many people heard about the country, and for sure on football level, it put the country on the map. And for every player, for every coach, it must be a dream and ambition to go once to the World Cup. The reason I'm a national team coach is very clear. I want to go to the World Cup. That's also the reason that I was this year very close to sign with Nigeria and also with other countries in the past, because my main ambition was never driven by money, but always driven by achieving the highest, going to the World Cup. I believe it's possible. Two games are played. We are fifth position. We have to be in the top three, or if needed, to the fourth position and playoffs. But there are still eight games to go. The president said it already very clear. 24, 28 March are crucial. By the way, 29 March is my birthday, so I hope I have a pleasant birthday that moment. But they are crucial for the future of Trinidad and Tobago football, men's football, but also for my future. If we can achieve good results against Panama and against Mexico, we are back in the running and everything is possible to go to Russia. If these results are negative, then doesn't matter how long your contract is, then every coach knows that he is on the end responsible for that. And I take it like that. I'm convinced, but I'm here not to do the job alone. Trinidad has a lot of good coaches, local coaches, technical team of people who know the league better than me, who know the mentality of the players. And for me, it's very important as a coach when you come to a foreign country that you try to understand the history, the culture, and the habits of the people, that you adapt and that you work very close together with local people. And my aim is naturally to work close not only with the Federation Technical Committee and the assistants I have there, but also with the local coaches on different level, to consult them, to hear from them, their opinion, their ideas, their vision, because it's not one person who will achieve this result. And to say it in your own motto, together we aspire, together we achieve. And I think that's very important. This will be not the job of Tom Saintfiet, this will be the job of 1.3 million Trinidad and Tobago people who work together to reach and our goal to go to the World Cup. So I will use the coming days, weeks and months to talk a lot, to observe a lot. I saw yesterday already two league matches. And I will live here full time, watch as most as possible league matches. And the goal is that I'm going to work very close with the local based players. We know that we have some good players in Europe. We have a lot of players in Mexico and United States. But we have also good quality players, talented and more experienced players who play in the local league. And I think it's a gift for every coach to work very close with local players who most of the time even are more proud and honored to defend their country, who can use the national team also to build further their career, because going to the World Cup could help every player individual to reach higher goals in his professional career. So I'm going to work on a daily basis. Next week we're going to start with training camp to prepare the World Cup matches. But after the league in February, we have also about a month time to work very close on a daily basis in training camp with local players, local based players. In these training camps, we can work on the physical skills, the condition, what's a very important part in modern football. When I analyze the games against Costa Rica, Honduras and other games on the internet, then I have to say that also the transition in football from defense to attack, the speed in these actions is very important. There are some things we have to work on together with the local coaches. I'm there to assist everyone, not only to listen, but also to assist. If people need my advice, we're going to work together on that. And in these local training-based training camps, we have every day the time to prepare the players physically, but not only that, also tactically, because tactical approach will be maybe something different than under the former coach. I'm a result-orientated coach. That's the first thing, and I think in the situation we are, we don't have to think about nice football. We need to win. We need to bring success back, and the moment we get results, then we can start making it more nice. But first priority is getting good results in our qualifier games for Gold Cup and World Cup. So that tactical approach we're going to do. And last but not least is the mentality. For me, playing, let me first start with myself, for me coaching a national team is the highest anyone as a coach can achieve. I'm very honored to be here to be the national team head coach of a beautiful, strong football nation as Trinidad and Tobago. But I expect also from every member of the staff and every player who will be selected that he has the same feeling. Playing for your country is not a motivation of money, it's a motivation to defend your country. You represent 1.3 million people. You have once in a lifetime chance to go to or Gold Cup, and once in a lifetime for sure to a World Cup. So I think it's something when you are selected, you have to come here, not on a holiday when you come from abroad. It's not, hey, nice to visit my family and my friends / girlfriends. No, it's you come here to work in discipline, respecting the rules, because I'm a strict disciplinarian. I will ask the Federation to make a code of conduct. I will ask also security in the hotel so that we know that players are focused on their job, and their job here will be playing for the national team and winning matches for the country, and we all together have to control that. So the mentality of players who will be selected will be also crucial to achieve the result. I think I spoke a little bit about myself. I spoke the reason why I'm here and also a little bit about perspective. Tactically, what my plans are, I will not unveil at the moment because it's also a little bit too early. What I say now can be in 1 week a little bit different after working closely with the players. We know that for the Gold Cup, we will be not able to select maybe all European players, maybe none of the European players. So we have to maybe change some tactical plans, especially for these matches. And the coming days and weeks when I work with the players, I will introduce you more to my tactical thoughts, but we will have time for that. To finish, I will be also available to answer your questions. But again, I'm here to achieve something. I believe that I have everything what it takes to bring Trinidad to the Gold Cup and my biggest ambition to the World Cup. But again, it's not me. It's a work of a team of people, of everyone who loves football. We all work together, and I'm always there to listen or to advise where necessary. And let's bring the glory back to this country. I will do everything all I can to achieve that. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is the new national senior men's head coach, Tom Saintfiet.